Hey guys, Ivan here, and in this video I want to show you how to track your affiliate sales using ClickMagick, which is a third-party tracking tool that I have been using for the past 5 years to track my affiliate sales for different networks such as ClickBank, MaxBounty, Digistore, and so on. And it's 2022, so a lot of things have changed, and so I decided to make an updated video to show you how to track sales if you have a landing page. Which is generally what I teach on this channel, is if you have a landing page and you take people straight to the offer, all right? So if you don't have a ClickMagick account, head over to go.ivanmana.com/clickmagick, sign up, you will get a 14-day free trial, and you can follow along with me. And I'm assuming most of you already have a ClickMagick account, which is why you're watching this video, but just in case. So there's that. I also do assume that you have a landing page set up. So I use Unbounce. I have been using them for about 3 to 4 years now. If you don't have an Unbounce account, head over to go.ivanmana.com/unbounce. I give you 14-day free trial and 20% off, okay? And I have tons of videos showing you how to create a landing page. So I'm assuming you already have a landing page because what I'm about to show you here, we're gonna get right into it and we're gonna add code to the page, okay? So just make sure that you guys already have these two things. And of course, one last thing, you have to have a product. So I'm in my test account here, test ClickBank account. I'm not approved for Steelbyte Pro in this test account, but we're just gonna use this offer here, just any random offer really, just for simplicity's sake to show you as an example, okay? So I'm assuming you have ClickMagick, assuming you have a landing page, and I'm assuming that you have an offer that you wanna promote, okay? That said, let's get straight into it. So the first thing we're gonna do is head over into ClickMagick and we're gonna click on campaigns. So if you guys have your own landing page, I do suggest that you use campaigns. It is by far the superior tool. Tracking links is still great if you want a direct link, and direct linking is still a good strategy, but I do suggest creating a landing page and using campaigns. So once you're here, what you're gonna do is click on new project, and let's suppose we want to, you know, this is our page, so we're gonna say Steelbyte Pro again. Steelbyte Pro, let's say 2022. You're gonna select your time zone, you're gonna select your currency, you're gonna click on create new project. And now you're gonna have the option, they just give it to you automatically here, so it's very easy, just follow the steps to add the code. So I'm here with you, so you don't have to go to the website code wizard. If you were doing this on your own, you could obviously click this option, but I'm gonna show you all the steps so you don't have to worry about it. So we're gonna click on custom code here, just for simplicity. And we're gonna add this click tracking code to the landing page, okay? And only the landing page. So we're not adding this code anywhere else. And usually I add this code to the body of my page. So if we head over back to our landing page, I'm gonna click on edit. And we're gonna add this code to the body section. And that's what's gonna allow us to track the clicks to this page. And actually we already have this here. I think we did it before. Let me delete this. That was for my other videos probably. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna come back here, we're gonna click copy, and then we're gonna come back to this page, we're gonna say, let's see, where's the, so we're gonna close out of that, we're gonna click here, we're gonna click add new JavaScript. And then here we're gonna just paste, so I just did Control V to paste, and I'm gonna say ClickMagick tracking code. So you can really put this anywhere. I think for me, I put it after the body tag, so that's where I put mine, but it doesn't ultimately matter. If you want this code to load as fast as possible when the page loads, then you would probably want to put it in the head. But for me, I've been putting it in the body tag without any issues, okay? So this is going to be our code. As you can see here, this is the name of the project, all right? And we're going to click done. So we're going to come back here, and that's it for this part. Now, step two is if you do want to track conversions, let's say you have your own product, you could go in and put this page on the page following your order form page, right? So on the order, on the sales confirmation page. If you're collecting emails, you would probably want to put this on the thank you page. So if I was collecting emails here, which it looks like I am, but for the sake of this video, I actually won't be. If I have a thank you page, then what you would do is you would take this code and you would simply put it in the same section on that thank you page. So you would go into JavaScript, you would say add new JavaScript, and you would put that code on your thank you page after collecting someone's email, right? And so if somebody enters their email and they go to that page, you will see an action here, right? Now, again, for the purpose of this video, we're not doing any of that. We're taking people straight from landing page to the affiliate offer. So that is it for this part. We've added the code. We're good to go here. So this is our project, Steelbyte Pro 2022. And we've set up the project. So you're going to see all the stats here, and it's going to track all the clicks, right? Now, how do you actually track the sales? So we're going to take our affiliate link here. So I'm going to click on promote. We're going to say create hop link. We're going to copy this link. We're going to go back into ClickMagick. We're going to click on edit. Nope, we're going to click on tools. We're going to click on affiliate link builder. And over here, first, we're going to select the network. So in this case, it's ClickBank. And this is why, by the way, I'm showing you this general overview of how to do it so that you know how to do it with any affiliate network, right? If I show you how to do it with just ClickBank, you'll be wondering, well, how do I do it with other networks? Well, here you go. Here's how you do it. You're going to go into tools. You're going to go into affiliate link builder, and you're going to select your network here. So in our case, it's ClickBank affiliate. We're an affiliate. We are using campaigns here, and all we're going to do is paste this link here. We're going to say update my affiliate link, and ClickMagick is going to automatically do all this for you, okay? So this TID is the parameter that ClickMagick uses specifically. Sorry, not ClickMagick, ClickBank. This is the parameter that ClickBank uses to pass the sales information through. And this here, CMCVID, is the ClickMagick token to pass through the ID from the click, from the original click. Don't worry if it sounds too complicated. I actually do have a video explaining exactly how a postback URL works for those of you that are interested. For those of you that don't care, just look at the steps and follow the steps. That's all you have to know, really. If you were selecting a different network, let's say, I know a popular one is Digistore 24 or MaxBounty. Let me just show you quickly the difference. So if let's suppose this would be the MaxBounty link, you would click update the link, and then MaxBounty uses S2, right? So the token is still the same because this is still what ClickMagick uses, is CMCVID, but the token here is different. The parameter that MaxBounty uses is S2. It's a little different, but we're going to go back. We're going to actually type in ClickBank to speed it up a little bit. I'm going to click update the link. And this is the link, guys, that we're going to be using on our landing page to send people to this offer, okay? So this was our affiliate link. And this here, this part, what they have here, is what we have to add to the end of the link to successfully be able to track sales. So I'm going to click copy URL. I'm going to go into our landing page. And again, imagine we're not collecting emails. Oops. Okay, I'm going to undo that. Let me just add a button here instead. Add a button like that. And for simplicity's sake, we'll delete that. We'll add this button and we'll say, let's say, click here to visit the real sales page or something, right? Whatever you can, depending on the offer, you can adjust it. I just want to show you what to, like the technical side of it, right? So for the technical side, we're going to go to the button, and then here under go to URL, we're going to paste this whole link here. Okay, and that's going to be our link right there. So it's the ClickBank affiliate link, and it's this TID value, right? And we're going to close out of that. We're going to hit save. We're going to hit publish, and we're going to quickly test it. And that should be it, guys, okay? So you should see all the sales data in ClickMagick. Now, depending on your exact affiliate network, you do have to do something on the back end as well. So if you're using ClickBank, you would have to use the secret key. If you're using MaxBounty, you would have to set up the postback URL there. If you're using Digistore, you would have to do the same thing. So I can't cover every single affiliate network in one video. That's just not realistic. So I do have videos showing you exactly how to set up the backend stuff, okay? So take a look at this, at those videos. I'll link them in the description. For the purpose of this video, I just wanted to show you the main thing, okay? It's just how to actually track the landing page stuff. And so now that you have this, if we go back here, go back into campaigns, this should be it. So if we test this, if we click on this page, actually, no, we can't click on this page because we have to use the UTM parameters first to actually be able to track. So we would have to go into URL builder and we would have to enter this URL here. So what you would be inputting into, let's say, Microsoft Ads or Google Ads is the link that you will get from here, okay? You cannot just use this link, it's not gonna track. So we're gonna build a link here. We'll say, let's suppose we're using Microsoft. Let's suppose we're using Microsoft Search Ads as opposed to Microsoft Display Ads. And let's suppose the campaign name here is still Byte Pro, okay? You can change these up. Again, I do have another video showing you how to use this, what this is. You can do that later. But for the purpose of this video, I'm just gonna show you how to use the link. So we're gonna save, click and copy. We're gonna open this in a new tab. And now we have all that information here. If we go back into ClickMagick, into our campaigns, not this one, we're going to select our Sealbyte Pro. And there you go. You see one visitor, right? And then if you go back here, now if we click on this link here, okay, you're not going to see anything yet. You're not going to see an action. You're not going to see, okay, it's a different page I haven't seen before. You're not going to see any actions, engagements, because we've only set up sales tracking, right? So assuming you set up the Postback URL correctly, you should see that the TAD value here, I'm using a redirect path Chrome extension, you should see the value here, this number, okay? You should see this number right there. And that number is the specific ID that ClickMagick and ClickBank use together. They communicate with each other to track sales so that this number will pass through to the end. ClickBank will then match the number that they get at the end with the initial click that ClickMagick got. They're going to match the number. And then that is how you're going to see a sale here. So if we go through all the way to the end, let me just quickly show you, you know, this is how you would actually test it. So I'm going to click on add to cart. And this is how you would check it to make sure everything is correct. So when you go to the order form page, you should see your affiliate ID, which in my case is my good Echo. That's the ID of my ClickBank account. And this value here, right? And this is the value that ClickBank is going to use later on once there is a sale to communicate with ClickMagick and ask, hey, ClickMagick, what number is this for which click? ClickMagick is going to say, hey, it's for this click that corresponds to this visitor. And if there's a sale, boom, ClickMagick is going to show you a sale right here. Okay. And that is all there is to it, guys. That is how you're going to track these sales. If you have a landing page, like I said, depending on your affiliate network you're using, you would change it up. You would select a different affiliate link builder, and you would have to set up the Postback URL in the back end. But that is pretty much the meat and bones of it. Okay. So I hope you found value here. If you guys did enjoy this video, definitely take a look at my other YouTube videos. I have over 450 YouTube videos right now, 100% free. So much information. You guys can go through it all depending on what you need in terms of online marketing. I have Quora, I have LinkedIn, I have Google, I have Microsoft, I have landing page builders, everything you could possibly need to do with affiliate and online marketing. I also offer you guys a free guide at my website at ivanmana.com, where you can get a free 55-page affiliate marketing guide teaching you how to get started with affiliate marketing and potentially start making money today. And that is all for this video. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next one.